biggest sporting event, coming to you live from Russia on SBS.
Once every 4 years on this ball-shaped planet, language is no barrier. What language you speak.
The 2018 FIFA World Cup on SBS.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Craig Foster, SBS's Chief Football Analyst. Welcome to this live stream coming to you from SBS. I'd like to start by acknowledging the traditional owners of the land we're on today, the Cammeraygal people of the Gurungai Nation, and to pay my respect to Elders past, present and future. Today we launch SBS Learn's classroom resource, the Harmony Game, which celebrates the 2018 FIFA World Cup. Football is a central part of life, of course, here at SBS, and World Cups are a great opportunity to showcase the beautiful game and its role in assisting diversity, inclusion and multiculturalism. This is one of the reasons why I helped found the Harmony Game for the last World Cup, and I'm so excited to bring you another fantastic resource this year. SBS Learn worked with several organisations on this resource, one of which was John Moriarty Football, and we have John in the studio this morning. John Moriarty was the first Indigenous footballer ever selected to represent Australia and was inducted into the Football Federation Australia Hall of Fame in 2015. John belongs to the Yanyuwa people of his birthplace Borroloola in the Northern Territory. He co-founded Ballarindji with his wife Roz, and Ballarindji is renowned for their design work, including painting five Qantas aircraft with Aboriginal motifs. Among his many awards, John is recipient of the Order of Australia. Welcome, John. Thanks for joining me today.
Thank you, Craig.
You had a wonderful football career, of course, so many years ago. Take us through some of the highlights, firstly.
Yes, football's been a great part of my life. It introduced me to what the world is all about and accepted me as an equal, and football gave me a great start. And it's one of those games that I played when I was, started when I was 15 and joined the Scottish club. Port Thistle, they amalgamated with Port Adelaide. Then I ended up playing with Port Adelaide, then Juventus, which is the Italians. And the Italians really took me on board, and I was part of their community. And in those days, Aboriginal people were, you know, a bit pushed to one side a little bit, but I felt as if I belonged to Australia and the world just through football. Football gave me a great start. And with our first match in the interstate level, played in Perth, and Charlie Perkins and I played there, and that is my first time representing South Australia. And of course I played quite a number of games for South Australia, and that put us on the Australian map, and the football community, which really accepted and embraced me, and of course vice versa. It is good for us at the home that I was with, Charlie Perkins, Gordon Briscoe, Jerry Hill and I. And we're all part of the football family.
And, of course, back then you were also selected in one of the Australian squads, right? Tell us about that.
Oh, yes. After the championships, Australian championships in Melbourne, the chairman of selectors came up to me and said, congratulations, you've been selected for Australia. I said, oh, thank you very much, sir. And he said, we'll be travelling through to Southeast Asia to represent Australia. And that is a part of the good news. I received the news just a little later that FIFA had banned Australia because of the differences in administration, and that stopped me going to Asia and representing Australia. It was a sad part of my life, but that didn't stop me playing football, which I still keep in touch with many of the people that I played with in those early days, which is a long time ago.
Yeah, for all of us. What about today? Most of your work, of course, within football is back in your hometown of Borroloola, and is through your own foundation and John Moriarty Football. Tell everyone about JMF.
Yes, JMF was established by our business, and Roz and I. And of course, James, our son, is a mad soccer fiend as well. And we started the program in Borroloola because soccer gave me a great start in life. And the kids at Borroloola, in my view, are still very much disadvantaged in that community. And football, we believe, will give a lot of a huge start to the kids up there. And one of our big projects we did was take four boys and four girls to Brazil for the World Cup. And that was 4 years ago. And one of the outstanding kids there, Shay Evans, she was nearly about 13 at the time. Mm. She's now under the auspices of Alan Stajic and is playing top soccer, and she's part of our program. Mm. We've got five kids down here in Sydney at different schools, and all under the auspices of football and education and well-being, and that's through John Moriarty Football, which Roz and I are volunteers for our program. We have a good team back in Borroloola coaching the kids, not only Borroloola but Robinson River, on the almost on the Queensland border. And these are part of my tribal connections that we have up there in the bush.
Mm, and I've seen some of those players, Shay and others, come through. There's some incredible talent coming through. It's important, isn't it, that we continue to expand these programs for Indigenous Australia?
I think it's just it's a necessity, because so many kids can reach the international level if they have the opportunities, and there are very few opportunities for Aboriginal kids to come through from the grassroots level, which is a bit disturbing for people like myself, to have those Aboriginal kids come through from that grassroots level, be it in the bush or even some of the suburbs in the bigger cities or in the remote townships and towns in the remote areas. But we don't do that, and it's I'm afraid it just doesn't allow our kids to come through from the grassroots up, and that's many opportunities. Just imagine them playing in the EPL or even in France and Germany or in Spain. It'll be fantastic for them.
And we need, of course, more for Socceroos. We're going to the FIFA World Cup only in a couple of weeks, and we have some of the Matildas. Of course, many of the greatest athletes in Australia and in our history, including you, identify as Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander. Tell us about some of the star First Nations footballers around at the moment.
We have many that have come through the soccer. You've got Travis Dodd, Jade North, the Minicon boys and so on. You've got quite a heap of them. And it's a pity we don't develop more of those kids. But they've done a great job for their families and their little communities. But we've got to get more people up through that level to represent not only their clubs and their communities and families, but Australia and their states. So it's that sort of level that we'd like to push through. And as you know, you've been to Borroloola, Craig, and see those kids there and the talent that's there. But you can replicate that many times throughout this country, in the bush or in the cities, to get those kids up through the ranks to represent Australia.
And, of course, we have Kai Simon and others and Lydia Williams. We've got some fabulous footballers, but we need many more.
You've got the girls coming through, which is fantastic.
Exactly.
Lydia and Kai, they've been very good.
Yeah, so SBS Learn worked with JMF, John Moriarty Football, classroom teachers and Football United, of course, to develop the Harmony Game. What values and life skills do you think football can teach young people on and off the pitch?
Oh, look, it's there's so much they can learn from it. Education's a good thing, well-being, and mixing and meeting with a broader community, and education brings that around, but football brings that around too, because that just levels everyone on that playing field, and they feel as if they're part of the community, part of the team, and that's where it can just broaden, and that's where Shay Evans, who's been part of our program, has just blossomed, and she's a real inspiration for our kids that's coming through the sport now.
And so I guess from your experience and also mine, the game also teaches you discipline, which is important, to be able to work together as a team as well. So I know up in Borroloola, they're big aspects of the program. Of course, many kids will be watching in classrooms this video, and the message is around discipline, working extremely hard, playing together as a team, not always individual. Those are the things football teaches all of us.
Look, discipline is a very important part of it, and the educational aspect comes through very well too. But the discipline from that level right on the field, on the playing pitch, you know, the training pitch, and then come through and on the field, and then you can see by the people, the supporters around, that they can come through very, very easily. And they're tailor-made for that game. for our great round ball game. And it's just one of those things that I'm very, and of course, footballers like yourself as well, are very keen to develop and bring to the forefront of this nation.
In history, of course, we had greats like Harry Williams also played in the 74 World Cup and so many others, but many of us, including the great Johnny Warren and Les Murray, who worked with us here at SBS, two of the great legends, icons of Australia and of our game, believed that Indigenous footballers would ultimately be our best players and perhaps one day some of the best players in the world. Do you agree?
Look, I couldn't agree with you more, and I hope that eventuates, you know. And people like Johnny Warren, Les Murray had great concepts like yourself, Craig, and that should be brought through to the forefront. And you got people like Harry Williams played in the World Cup series over in Europe, and I saw him play in the World Cup, went over there especially to see him. And it's one of those things that brought to the forefront what Aboriginal people can do in this community and for this country. And they've got to be made part of that, in my view.
So one of your great passions is bringing through these young Indigenous people. And if you could go back and talk to a young John Moriarty, or indeed any of the young players listening and watching today, what would your advice to them be?
I think play the game, stick to the rules, learn from all the what the coaches can teach you and the education that goes all around that, and you will just blossom very, very quickly, but also to your abilities. And you will be part of the Australian community through this representative great game of ours, football.
Wonderful. Well, we thank you, John, for joining us this morning and contributing to the SBS Learn, a classroom resource, the Harmony Game. So thanks for being here.
Thank you very much, Craig.
OK, so head to the SBS Learn webpage that's on your screen for free classroom materials, including worksheets in Mandarin, Arabic, Spanish, French, Russian and, of course, English. And don't miss a moment of the 2018 FIFA World Cup live and free on SBS TV and SBS Radio just this month. It's so close now. Thank you so much for joining us, and do enjoy the FIFA World Cup. Hi, I'm Craig Foster, SBS World Cup host. SBS Learn is creating a fantastic resource for teachers in the lead-up to the 2018 FIFA World Cup in Russia.
Be the first to know and get your copy of the Harmony Game. Sign up to the SBS Learn newsletter today for exclusive updates.
And catch all the Socceroos matches live on SBS as official broadcaster of the 2018 FIFA World Cup.